Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we are going to learn how to make a simple bowley or similar to a pong game in Scratch. So let's get started. We'll create or choose a backdrop now. I'll choose basketball one and we'll go to backdrops and we'll delete this. And now we'll duplicate this one and we'll write game over. I need this in red, so I'll take the color red and I'll change the font and I'll enlarge it now and little bit decrease in yes. This is good. And now we'll code the game so that if whenever we click this green flag to start a new game or start over again, it must go to the first backdrop, not this game over one. So we'll go to looks. When click the green flag, switch backdrop to basketball one, means that plain one. Let's test this. And as you can see, it worked. Now we need three sprites. One a soccer ball. Another one a goalie. And a red line. We'll first place this red line over here. At the bottom. Okay. We'll now go to the goalie. We'll go to costumes. Now we'll delete all the goalie costumes except this E one. And now it's good to go. And now we'll take this goalie and place here a little bit above the red line. Right here, and we'll place this ball here. Okay, now we'll code the goalie. We need the goalie to move in its x-axis as the mouse moves in its x-axis. So x-axis of the mouse and the goalie should be same. So we'll go to events, where click the green flag, we'll go to control and put a forever loop. We'll go to motion and set x to, we'll go to sensing and we'll take mouse x. Now let's try this and it's working, so I'll stop it. And now we'll go to soccer ball. The ball, I want the ball to start it from here, start the game from here. So I'll go to events, take this start command, and I'll go to motion and go to x0 y144, this position of the ball when clicked the green flag. So I'll bring it here for now and we'll test it. Yes, it's working. Now the ball should move from one side to another, so it should bounce around. So go to events, when the green flag is clicked, yes, when the green, we'll continue this code. I'll remove this. Then we need the ball to turn about a 59 degrees and then move, or else it will take random degrees. So I'll take this, move 59 degrees. No, turn 59 degrees and move. Then I'll take a forever loop. And I'll go back to motion. Then I will take move 15 steps. And then if it touches on edge, it should bounce. So if on edge, bounce. So the code is ready. Let's bring it. Yes. As you can see, the ball is bouncing. and it's good. So let's stop the command. Now I need the ball to bounce back or go back if it touches the goalie. So we'll code the ball so that it does that. I'll take this command and I'll go to control forever. I'll take the if command. If the soccer ball is touching the goalie, I'll go to motion. I'll take turn 180 degrees and then move 15 steps again. Okay, now I need to add a delay so that if it touches it, it should wait for some time to get released. So I'll add a delay of about 0.5 seconds. And yes, and also I want that when the ball touches the goalie, it should make sounds like boink or something. So I'll duplicate this command. I will remove this. I'll go to sounds. I'll take the sound boink. Oh, sorry, not this. I'll take boink. This. And I'll go back. And I'll go to sounds. Play a sound boink until done. So let's test this. As you can see, it's good, and we'll stop it. And also I need a scoreboard over here, so I'll go to variables. I'll make a variable called score. Yes, and now I will take change score by 1 if it touches the goalie. I'll put it right here. Yes, and then when the game is over and when the ball, everything stops, the score, when I click this green flag, the score should go back to 0. So I'll take when clicked the green flag, set score to 0. Yes, now we'll code the line. I want the line that if the soccer ball touches the line, the game should stop and so game over. So I'll take when green flag is clicked, I'll go to control forever. If the ball is touching the red line, the soccer ball, then go to looks, switch backdrop to basketball 2. Now I will duplicate this command and take it here, and I'll take this out and go to control, stop all actions. Yes, and now the game is ready. Let's test it. I'll click the green flag now. As you can see, the game is working and the points are increased by 1 every time the ball touches the goalie. And now I'll let the ball touch the red line and see if it works. And now kind of, let's test again. Yeah, as you can see, it worked. And yeah, if you like the video, and also it's the end of the video, if you like the video, please like this and hit the like button and hit the bell icon after subscribing to the channel to get instant notification of any new video. And thanks for watching till the end. If you have any suggestions for me, please write it in the comment section, and I would love to read your comments. And yeah, Please try this game in Scratch on your own. And yes, I'll be coming up with more videos of coding. And yes, thank you. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.